A very good evening to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. This is Rajiv and here we have two videos, one with the green screen and another one without green screen but with lower third. So first have a look on this video where I am using a green screen for the background and then we have that lower third animation on top of it and then we have another video on which I am using the same lower third without green screen, that is overlapping that lower third over that video. So that is what you are going to learn today. And here we have our presentation and this is a green screen wallpaper, or you can also use a fill color. Let me delete this one, this rectangle here, and then right click on an empty area of the background and choose format background, and here you can use solid fill to fill a green color in the background. But make sure that you are not using the same color in any of your objects, so you have to take care of that before you start making your lower third. So as we have this lower third here, and I want to use this like, share and comment lower third in my another videos, and let me show you one more thing here. So this animation is basically inspired from one of the lower thirds in Camtasia Studio 2018, and that is lower thirds sliding boxes 01. Let me show you the preview. And the same lower third has been created in PowerPoint using the inbuilt animation effects. So let me show you the presentation here, and here I am going to open the animation pan from the animations tab. And here you can see all the animations that I have applied to create this lower third with the green background. So let me show you the preview once more. So very simple animations has been used. As you can see that here we have this blue rectangle. If I move it up, then you can see another light green rectangle in the background, and if I move it up as well, and then you will see a red rectangle here. So we basically have three rectangles which are coming from the left, and the red is coming first, then the lighter green one following, and then the blue one, and they all three have the different speeds. And then you see the yellow rectangle coming from the right side to left, and then the text appear, and on the top you will see another small red rectangle with the text coming in. So the same effects has been used on this presentation, and as you can see that first we will take the red rectangle, and that is coming with the duration of 1.15 seconds with fly in effect from left, and then we have the green rectangle with same fly in effect with different duration 1.25, and then finally we have the blue rectangle with a greater duration timing, and that is 2 seconds. And if I open the effect option window, then you can see that I am using the default smoothness, and you can do experiments with these smoothness option here. And then we are showing the like, share and comment text, and that is also coming from the left side. But here one thing you have to note, that in this animation I am using by letter for animating the text with a 10% delay between each letter. So that is what I have changed in this presentation, and you can increase the timing or decrease the delay between letters. And for the yellow rectangle I am using the peek in effect, and that is from the right side. And for the red rectangle I am also using the peek in effect, and that is from the bottom, and that red rectangle is behind this blue rectangle. And then for the text again I am using the same animate text by letter with a 10% delay timing, and for this text I am using the zoom in effect, and then I am shrinking and auto reversing the same text with a 120% grow and shrink rate, and that is 2 by letter, and I can add a delay timing here. And let me show you the slideshow again. Okay, that's fine. And then we again have this same effect, the zoom in effect for this channel name here, and it has the same properties by letter 10% with zoom in effect. And then I am again using the grow shrink effect on this text as well, and here I am going to apply a 2% delay between each letter. So this way it will show each letter one by one. Then again I am using the same effects, but this time with exit animation. As you can see here, to make this like, share and comment text disappear, I am using the fade out effect from the exit animations here, this one. And then for the don't forget, again actually that is zoom out effect, and that is from the exit animations, these ones. If you click more exit effects, then you will see that effect right here. And again for the channel, I am using the same zoom out effect. To remove the small yellow rectangle from the screen, I am using peak out, and the direction of this peak out is to top. And to remove that small red rectangle right here, I am again using the peak out effect, and this time the effect option is to bottom. And these three rectangles, blue, green and red rectangles, are going out with the fly out effect. All three have these different duration timing. As you can see that for the blue I am using 0.75 seconds, and for the green rectangle I am using 1 second, and for the red rectangle I am using 1.25 seconds duration timing. So that is how you can create lower thirds in PowerPoint 2016. That is just an example and the beginning of creating lower thirds in PowerPoint 2016. So now I am going to tell you that how you can use these lower thirds in your other videos. So once you have created this lower third, what you can do, you can go to the file menu and then click export, then click create a video, and then click create video. You can also watch one of my video regarding how to export your PPT files to MP4 format. And here I am going to export this video on desktop with the same name. Click save, and that will start exporting your PPT file to MP4 format. So once you have that lower third in MP4 format, let me show you here, this one. So now we will see that how we can use this lower third without green background. So let's say if you are already creating tutorial videos or any other kind of video for your YouTube channel, then you might already be using a screen recording software, like I am using Camtasia Studio. However, I can use this preloaded lower third inside the Camtasia from the library. I can drag and drop it right like this and can use this lower third in my other videos. But what I am showing you here is how you can create lower thirds in PowerPoint and then can use those lower thirds in your other videos without the need of preloaded Camtasia Studio lower thirds. That is because in PowerPoint 2016, you can customize all of the animations that you require. Whereas in this Camtasia Studio, however, you have many options here like behavior, transitions and animations like these one. And you can also configure this preloaded lower third in Camtasia Studio as well. But as you know that you have more customization option in PowerPoint 2016, and you can make better lower thirds in PowerPoint. So I am going to import that video inside the Camtasia Studio, and for that I am going to the media tab and then click import media, and here I am going to import two different videos. One will be the lower third with the green screen that we have created in our last presentation, and then I will drag it right here on the second track. On the first track, you can import that video on which you want to overlap this lower third. And again, I'm going to import another video, and this time I'm going with lighthouse. So here I imported this lighthouse video and going to drag it on the track one. So keep in mind that the lower third will be on the top track. So here I'm going to forward it right here. Let me move it further and let's see the background video. You can temporarily hide this timeline by clicking on this I button. So I need to put down this lower third right at this point. So let me turn on this eye and then place this lower third that we have created in PowerPoint 2016 right here at this point. So if now I show you the preview of this timelines here, then you will only see the lower third with green screen and not the first video that we have on the track 1. That is because the track 2 is overlapping track 1 with the green screen. So the last thing that we need to learn is how to remove that green screen here so you can see the background video. And that is very simple in Camtasia Studio. And you might find the same option in any other screen recording softwares as well. So for that, in Camtasia Studio, you need to click on this More button and then go to Visual Effects. And here you need to put this effect here, remove a color. As you can see that this guy is showing you that how you can remove that green screen, and then just drag this effect on the top of your lower third. So once you have this, and you can click this arrow to see the effect that you have applied, and if you double click this effect, then you will see the property of that effect right here in the right side pane. So here you already have the green color here, but what you can do if that is a slightly different color, then you can click this drop down arrow and then choose pick a color and then just click on your green color. And that way it will remove the green color from your lower third. So once you get this, you can create as many lower thirds you want in PowerPoint 2016. Like you can also create subscriber button and like button or sharing button. So I hope you will find this tutorial useful. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have